helped draft that legislation?
Yeah, it was something that I worked on a long time. It actually took 13 years because it took most of that time to get the approval from the legislature to be able to do it. So it was passed by the council in 2014. It has a lot of unique features which help candidates run viable grassroots campaigns. So it provides a substantial public match for small donors who reside in the county. And the whole point is to empower small donors to give candidates an incentive to seek them and to encourage more competition. And it seems to be accomplishing that so far. We've got a lot of people who are considering running for county office in 2018, 20 or 30 possibly for the at-large positions alone.
Did you have any thought that this is the kind of reaction the public financing would get?
Well, I thought it would be something that would be well used, and it was designed to be something that would be appealing to all candidates, not just to challengers, but also to incumbents. It's something that you want people to use. If people don't use it, then it doesn't do any good.
Right.
And the council deserves credit for funding it. The council has appropriated $11 million for the public financing fund so that it's available to candidates. And I think it will very much encourage candidates to seek out small donors. And only small donor contributions from county residents are eligible for matching public funds. That's important. But unlike many public financing laws, while a candidate who participates must limit their contributions to $150 and only from individuals, there's no limit on how many of those contributions they can receive overall. So there is not an overall spending limit or overall contribution limit in terms of what they can raise, but they can't take any funds. Candidates who participate in public financing cannot take any dollars from PACs, corporations, unions, or political parties, or any group.
Is there any chance that this could get too popular?
Well, that's a good problem to have, first of all. And if it gets to the point where the council needs to add money to the fund in order for candidates to receive the amount of contributions they're eligible for, the council can do that. The council has that authority to do it. The amount they've appropriated, $11 million, I think is in the ballpark of what's going to be needed, even with a large number of candidates participating. At this point, there are approximately 17 candidates running for county office who have indicated they plan to seek public financing. A few have qualified already in terms of raising the threshold amounts. So if for some reason 6 months from now it looks like $11 million is insufficient, the council can do a special appropriation and add whatever is needed. And I think they probably would, given the support there is on the council for this. This was unanimously supported by the council, but it is clearly something that appeals to challengers too, and there are both Democrats and Republicans seeking to use it, and a Green Party candidate as well.